In this example, we are required to determine the wavelength that hydrogen atom will emit if its electron makes a transition from N2 equals to 4 to N1 equals to 2. So here we first need to calculate the amount of energy liberated, or we can write the photon energy liberated in this process will be delta E, which can be written as E4 minus E2. That is, according to Bohr's third postulate, energy difference of the two energy levels will be emitted in form of an electromagnetic photon. And the fourth energy level energy is minus 0.85 electron volt, we already studied. And that of the second energy level is minus of 3.4 electron volt. So on calculation, this will give us 2.55 electron volt. If this energy is emitted, we can directly write, if lambda is the wavelength of emitted photon, here we can write this energy delta E is equals to hc by lambda, so the value of wavelength will be hc over delta E. If we substitute the values, this will be h is taken as 6.63 into 10 to power minus 34 multiplied by speed of light is 3 into 10 to power 8 divided by the energy is 2.55 multiplied by 1.6 into 10 to power minus 19. Here we need to substitute the values in joules to convert the wavelength in meters. And if we wish to convert it into angstrom, we can also divide it by a factor of 1 by 10 to power minus 10. So units will be converted from meters to angstrom. So in this situation, on simplifying the values, we are getting the value of wavelength as 4875 angstrom. That will be the answer to this problem. And in coming sections of this topic, we'll study the direct calculation in terms of these constant by substituting their constant values. And in coming examples of this topic, you will see similar problem or the application of such problems where wavelengths are required to be calculated by direct calculation methods.